am I? What's happening? I'm trapped in a storm? How did I get here? And where is here? So surreal.
Famously called film Little Pieces of Time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay. These I'm in class. Everything's cool. I am okay.
From light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white?
I didn't fall asleep, and that Anybody? Sure didn't feel like a dream.
Bueller.
Weird.
Diane Arbus.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear the class laughing at me now.
Because of her images of hopeless faces, you feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw humanity as tortured, right? And frankly, it's bullshit.
I can't believe I still have this pencil case. But I like it old school.
And capture you in a
moment. I haven't kept up with my journal as much as I should.
Any one of you could do that to me.
My little camera bag is battered, but still kicking.
Too obvious?
If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
What if Arbus chose to capture people at the height?
I do love my analog camera. I should take a quick picture now. So,
she could have taken another approach.
I have to admit, I'm not a big fan of her work.
I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift. Of course, as you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits.
You're asking me? Let me think.
You either know this or not, Max. Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes, a process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria. The Daguerrean process brought out fine detail in people. The first American daguerreotype self-portrait was done by Robert Cornelius.
Sorry, Max. No more selfies right now.
In your textbook. Or even...
Look at this crap. How can I show this to...
And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Yes, Victoria doesn't waste a second. Kate looks so sad and quiet today. Poor thing. Hi, Kate.
Oh.
I know,
Hi, Max.
I just worked so hard on the shot, and I'm sure you know what it's like to be consumed.
Kate, I hope I didn't embarrass you with my lame answer.
It sucks to be dragged into the spotlight.
Unless you're Victoria.
She's got nothing on you, Max. Well, I should get going.
Yeah, me too. Talk to you later.
Sure.
I don't want anybody to feel excluded from this process, but...
Now I wish I wouldn't have read this. Purge.
I also want everybody to know that this photographic world is not for everybody.
Obviously, Blackwell spent bank on the computers here. Looks like somebody was already working on this. Cool. That was amazing when Mr. Jefferson took a class picture the first week. Even though I didn't want to be in the picture at all, it was fairly fucking cool to watch him at work framing. Damn, they have carbon fiber tripods here. The ball head even has a pan lock? God, I'm such a photo nerd. Of course, Victoria has to have the bestest, newest, most expensive everything. I should have known. She'll have better equipment than Blackwell. Even her school books are gift wrapped. I can't believe she made fun of me in class. What is she, 15 years old? And people laughed. Every time I look at Victoria, I feel like she's talking smack about me. This is ridiculous. I always get so shy and nervous around Mr. Jefferson. Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria. Excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
I didn't have any time. Way too much homework.
Max, you're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you, but life won't wait for you to play catch-up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others. And that's what separates the artist from the amateur.
You can never escape the lighthouse here. Even in pictures, the forest around here always looks mysterious. Man, he even has the best plasma HDTV for a class monitor. Can't wait to watch some more documentaries on this bad boy.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to.
You always welcome to the real world.
Cute.
Hot.
Then I might send you a special picture of Chinese class.
Because Max wants everybody to see how cute she is.
She plays it so sharp.
I need a serious time out in the bathroom. Splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
I hate that class. It's so fucking boring.
She's so fucking shy. She takes selfies with this giant camera.
Oh.
Ivan doesn't say much to me, but his photos are very cool. Alyssa is always texting, but she doesn't hang out with a lot of people. Imagine a world without you. There's Taylor, always waiting for Victoria. I think that's Courtney. She's such a slave to Taylor and Victoria. Driving a car by the seaside. Ah, the science room. Here's the portal to Warren's brain. These missing persons posters are popping up everywhere. To all of you, I shouldn't be so stingy with my blood. Girls in the movies, no one can tell where your heart is. American, I hate having everybody see inside my locker. With shiny smiles, I love that picture of mom and dad. Hello, Jack. Kiss, kiss. Andy, you look totally fabulous, as usual. Yes, this poster must stop bullies dead in their tracks. Stella is always deep in her notes. She didn't come to Blackwell to mess around. That's Dana talking to, I think his name is Justin. Dana is on my floor too. She's such an archetypal, gorgeous cheerleader. They must make them in a factory. I shouldn't be so catty. Dana is nice to me. Walking around my own place, I've seen Brooke hanging out with Warren. She seems like his type. Talking about her, I hate bully jockstraps like Logan. Andy's a Vortex Club member. Poor Daniel, he's so nice. I wish I could beat the shit out of Logan. Till she got tired to complain. That's when I fly. They should just call it a sugar machine. That would be awesome if you put money in there and a bag of sugar dropped out. There's Juliet from my dorm. Yet another Vortex Club disciple. Figures Juliet will be dating Zachary. Jocks sucked up in the Vortex Club. God, Samuel is such a weirdo. But I kinda like that about him. He's cute. I like skater boys. Too bad they don't like me. The Bigfoot stomp. I should develop some school spirit. Go team. Rachel Amber. She's so pretty. I hate these posters. So sad. Miss Grant is a great science teacher. Principal doesn't come out of his office much. Good thing I left my AK at home. To all of you, American girls, it's sad to imagine a world without you. American girls, empty, good. Like nobody can see my meltdown. Except for me. Now, who would bother to write that crap? The last time I got a flu shot, I got the flu. Fuck you. I feel like the universe is taunting me everywhere I go today. It all started with that bizarro dream in class. Am I going crazy? Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift. Thank you. when a door closes, a window opens. Or something like that. Okay, girl, you don't get a photo op like this every day. This poster must drive people to have. Whoa, where did that butterfly come from? It doesn't look like any kind I've ever seen before. The blue wings are practically glowing. I can almost feel the air moving around me. The butterfly feels almost like a spirit.
It's cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three. Don't be scared. You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss. So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
That's my family, not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
Don't ever tell me what to do! I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs!
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
No!
Whoa. What the fuck? How can that be? I was in the bathroom. He shot that poor girl. I held up my hand. And then I was back here.
As he likely was. These pieces of time can frame us in.
I already heard this lecture.
From light to shadow. From color.
Now Kate is being hassled again. And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Now,
shit!
Can you give me an example of a photographer?
I cannot believe this.
Captured the human condition in black and white.
Okay, if I'm crazy, anybody? I might as well go all the way.
Bueller?
Diane.
Can I actually reverse time?
There you go, Victoria. Why are.
I did it.
Can you give me
I
an
actually
example
did
of a photographer
it.
Who perfectly captured
I'm a human
the human
time machine.
Anybody? Bueller?
Max,
Diane,
my pencil case is still in the same place.
There you go, Victoria.
Keep it together,
why
Max.
Because of her images of hopeless faces. You
when
feel
I took my selfie, Jefferson asked me a question. If he does again, I'll know this is for real.
And frankly, it's bullshit. Shh, 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 shh. Keep that to yourself. Seriously, though. I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
I know I'm not dreaming
of course,
this.
As you all know, the
it's
photo
real.
Portrait has been popular
I can tell.
Since the early 1800s. Your generation.
So
was
I can
the
go
first
back in time.
For selfie expression.
What if that girl isn't dead yet?
I couldn't resist. The point
can
remains
I save
that
her?
The portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please? But you're not going to get away that easy. We can talk more after class. Is there anybody
oh,
here
shit.
Who knows their stuff?
Jefferson wants to keep me
Months
after class.
Ago, was a French painter
and I need time to save that girl.
A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
What if I rewind
the
again
Bavarian process
and give him the right answer?
Fine detail in people's faces. Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please? tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits.
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing. Nice work, Max. The Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely popular, mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Max is so far way ahead of Evan. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Max, you are not crazy. You are not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
Yes, Victoria, you still...
Nice answer, Max. Are you okay? You look pale.
Kate, did we talk at all today?
This is the first time. What's wrong?
I'm sorry, I'm just tripping. Too much stress.
I know the feeling.
I just really think Everyday Heroes is an important cultural...
I have to go. Too much happening right now.
Sure.
Just by participating. By putting yourself out there in the world. Now, no matter who wins, this is just a bump on a bigger road. I don't want anybody to feel...
Victoria hasn't moved from that spot.
I also want everybody to know...
I wish I could go talk to Mr. Jefferson about what's going on. But I can't. Excuse me. Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes. Excuse you.
No, Victoria. Excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
I'm not sure I have one.
Given your selfie output, I'm sure you must have about 1,000 pics by now.
It'll take a long time to find a good one.
Max, don't wait too long. John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans. Go on now. Don't let me stop you. Fry, and everybody should have that
totally.
Shit.
Excuse me.
Photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
I'm on top of it. I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
Max, you're on fire today. All the right answers, good. Make sure you finish working on it by today. I have faith in you.
I hope I have enough time to get to the bathroom. Please, please. I can't tell anybody. They'll think I'm crazy.
Daniel, you tease me.
You know I don't tease.
I hate that science class with those nerds.
What's that got to do with anything?
Okay, Max, retrace every step. I washed my face. I shredded my photo. Then the butterfly flew in. And I took a photo.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come
don't
on, put that thing down!
Tell me what to do!
Wowzer, it's happening again!
People trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs!
Nobody would.
I need a hammer to break it open!
Yes, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Don't ever tell me what to do. I'm so sick of people trying to control me.
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
No way.
Don't ever touch me again, freak.
Another shitty day.
That didn't happen. This cannot be real. I just saw a girl get shot and then saved her. What the fuck is going on? Do not freak out.
you hear that fire alarm, that means you should be outside.
I had to use the bathroom.
Girls always use that excuse.
Excuse for what?
For whatever you're up to. Your face is covered in guilt.
The alarm tripped me out.
Then trip on out of here, Missy. Or are you hiding something? Huh?
Thank you, Mr. Madsen. The situation is under control. There's no emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone, and please turn off that alarm since that's your job. You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You can always be upfront with me, Max. Or have you done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
I just saw Nathan Prescott waving a gun around in the girls' room.
Nathan Prescott? You sure?
Yes. He was in the bathroom talking to himself with a gun. I saw everything. He was babbling like crazy.
Okay, slow down. Slow down. So now you saw this without him seeing you.
I was hiding behind a stall. I have the right to be there. It's the girls' room.
I know. I just want to be completely clear what happened. Mr. Prescott happens to be from the town's most distinguished family and one of Blackwell's most honored students. So it's hard for me to see him brandishing a weapon in the girls' bathroom. So what happened next?
Then he left. I ran out here wondering what to do. Are you gonna bust him?
This is a serious charge. I'll look into the matter personally. Thank you for bringing it to my attention.
That's it? After what I told
you? We'll continue this discussion later in my office. Please go outside with the rest of your class now, Miss Caulfield.
Of course this academic drone won't do anything, since the Prescott family owns Blackwell now. Should I rewind and change my story?
You look a little stressed out.
I just got sick in class. Female trouble.
Except you're wandering around like a zombie. And do you think that's the first time a student has used that line on me?
It's the truth. I felt dizzy in Mr. Jefferson's
class.
Just
tell me what you're hiding. You can trust me.
There's nothing to hide. I got sick. It happens, you know.
There's that teen toot again. You know, I've heard enough. Don't think I don't know what goes on around here. You've only been here for 3 weeks, and you're already causing conflict. I don't think your parents will approve when they find out. Now get outside with class. Please.
No, he does not buy that at all. I may have just flushed my scholarship down the toilet. Yes, I could rewind and actually tell him the truth.
Don't wander around here. Get on outside. You look a little stressed.
Just saw Nathan.
Nathan Prescott, please come to the front office. Thank you.
Miss Grant sure is dedicated to that petition. Hi, Miss Grant.
Excuse me, Max. I know everybody loves being asked to sign a petition, but would you do Miss Grant a favor and hear me out?
Sure, I always have time for you. What's the petition?
David Madsen, our chief of security, wants to put surveillance cameras all around the campus. Halls, classrooms, gym, dorm rooms, etc. Blackwell Academy should be a high school, not a high security penitentiary.
I guess cameras could have helped Rachel. I can see both sides.
You're fair-minded, Max. And we all pray Rachel is found safe and sound, bless her soul. But this petition isn't about her. Blackwell Academy has a noble heritage, from the Native Americans who founded this land to the pioneers who shared it in peace, not fear and violence.
The Native Americans?
The tribes who were here first, who welcomed the settlers. Both cultures found a mutual symbiosis and thrived. Now, before I assign you homework with this lecture, will you please sign the petition to keep our campus from going back to 1984?
Absolutely. I don't mind security, but not pure surveillance.
I knew you were my favorite new student at Blackwell for a good reason.
I would so be there if a Sasquatch actually did battle a Razorback. There's Hayden in his Vortex Club harem. He sure is living the dream. Hey, Hayden.
There she is, the retro selfie master.
That's me, all right. You look relaxed as usual, Hayden.
It's a skill one cultivates at Blackwell, especially when one represents the Vortex Club. Not to boast.
What the hell is the Vortex Club anyway? Seems so elitist.
Only if you're not cool enough to get in, and it doesn't hurt your resume.
If you say so.
I do. But you should actually come hang with us one night. Then you wouldn't be so inclined to gossip.
You mean hang with a Vortex Club? That sounds like a setup to a horrible prank.
Chillax, paranoia girl. We're not that desperate for fun. We know how to do that on our own.
It seems weird to think about partying with all those Rachel Amber posters up.
You're high. Rachel used to hang out with us too. She was a blast. Smart, not bitchy like, you know.
So you knew Rachel Amber?
I knew she liked to party. Fun to be around. Oh, yeah, and she was hot.
What do you think happened to her?
Whatever happens to people who disappear without a trace.
Did Victoria like Rachel? She seems like the jealous type.
Don't think you know Victoria so well. She respected Rachel, even if she didn't act like it.
Rachel was actually a member of the Vortex Club?
No. Rachel was like her own club. She was actually too cool for us. And I'll deny I ever said that.
Do you really want Nathan Prescott to represent?
Oh, please. Nathan is like everybody's voodoo doll. Kill the rich kid. He's all right and a fun guy to hang with. Fuck the haters.
Fair enough, but I'm still not going to party with him.
Your loss. Bro is fucking hilarious when he's blazed, and he does always have the best shit.
Let's talk later, Hayden.
Bye, Max. Now, I have to get my chemical on and study. We should get you and Dana out one night.
Brooke actually has a drone? Hi, Brooke.
Let me guess. You want to fly my drone?
Is that really yours? Is that even legal?
Of course. Nobody knows about it yet.
Isn't it considered a weapon of war?
You read too many conspiracy sites. This might be too complicated for you. Funny. Warren said you were smart. Please, step back.
Hi, Brooke.
Well,
I'd love to. I love planes and balloons and...
This is neither. Do you know what a drone really is?
A weapon, right?
You read too many
I'm almost sure Warren has the same bag. It looks a bit nerdy, though. What a complicated name for such a tiny drone. Hi, Brooke.
Let me guess.
That looks like a high-fly drone. Model B400 EVO. Now, that's a nice piece of tech.
You're full of surprises. Why would you know that?
I love aerial photography. Drones are perfect for that, especially those with great range. It's a new era of images.
Most impressive, Max. Warren said you were multifaceted. Here, give the drone a whirl around campus.
Okay, I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive. I bet the Blackwell founders would shit cats if they saw today's student body walking around like zombies on their phones. This is a great image. All those rippling green coins. I hope everybody got their wish. This day has been so insane. Everything is happening too fast. And none of it makes any sense. Getting to wake up one more time. But if this is a dream, then I'm not asleep. Which means somehow I did rewind time. So there has to be a reason. And I have to find out why. Stella always looks so serious and dedicated. Good for her.
Hey there, Stella.
Hey, I know you. You're the new quiet girl in Jefferson's class. Isn't he incredible?
He's aloof. He seems like he's always above you. Not like a snob, but like you don't know what's in his head.
Maybe. Mr. Jefferson just has his own style. If Victoria wasn't all over him, I would definitely make a move.
Now that you mention it, he doesn't respond to Victoria's flirting. That means he has good taste.
You have a lot to learn here at Blackwell. Rachel Amber absolutely had sex with him. Well, I heard that from a good source.
So, you knew Rachel?
Not really. I saw her hanging with the other cool kids like Victoria. Not my kind of clique. But I heard insane stories about Rachel.
That's so cool that Blackwell is doing a show of Mr. Jefferson's work. Daniel is always drawing something. He makes me look like an extrovert. What's up, Daniel?
Oh, hi, Max. Could I, ask you a question? Would you mind letting me sketch you? I do put my sketches on Facebook, though.
I'd be honored, Daniel. Makes me feel like a muse.
Funny you should say that. I was just thinking about my real muse. Rachel Amber.
You knew her?
No, but once she asked me to draw her portrait, oh, she was a natural.
So what happened to her? There's gotta be a story.
She just stopped coming to class. Some people said she ran away. Some say she jumped off a cliff. I just hope she's okay.
Hard to avoid her posters all over campus.
Kills me to see her sweet face used as a crime photo. She had a good heart.
Okay, why don't you start drawing me? Even though I must be a step down from Rachel.
No way! You're a good substitute, Muse. Oh, that's a good posture. Good. Good.
Best portrait ever.
Thanks, Max. I'd like to draw you another time if you want.
That was so cool. I'm glad I talked to him. Take more chances, Max. There's Justin and his skater posse. They're so cute doing their tricks. Yo, Justin.
Check out the Max. Come to Thrash?
Oh yeah? Bring it.
What's your first move gonna be?
Jump?
You're such a poser. If you can't even name a simple nose slide or a tray flip, you should walk on.
Yo, Justin. I came to nose slide. But I'd love to see somebody do a tray flip.
Oh, sick. You're not a poser.
Nah. I just can't skate worth shit.
Aw, check it. We're gonna destroy some rails for you. What do you want to see?
Go for a tree flip.
Let's get Trevor all over that action.
There's Justin and his skater posse. They're so cute doing their tricks. Oh, that's not nice. Poor little otter. Ew.
Ew, gross. At least switch to e-cigs. I think his name is Evan. He always looks so intense. Hey, Evan. Mind if I check out your cool portfolio?
Let's see if you're worthy of it, Max. You'll have to answer a simple question. Who photographed the famous falling soldier?
Robert Capa, of course. I love his work, despite the controversy about that photo.
My, my. This quiet child knows things.
That's why I'm here.
You're a kindred spirit, Max. Would you care for a perusal of my portfolio? It's not a privilege I grant to many.
I'd be honored, sir. Evan's portfolio always looks so uber pro. I'd love to see his photos in there. These photos are great. And Rachel Amber's face is mesmerizing. Hi, Evan.
As you can see, Rachel Amber was my favorite model here. She knew exactly what angles worked best with my eye.
You were close.
Like brother and sister in arms. She understood me, never judged me. I hated her Vortex Club clique, but she never acted like she cared. Her friends were her friends.
What do you think happened to her?
Nothing. Nothing good.
Clever. That's Luke Parker. Zachary pushed him into a locker last week. Go bullies. Hello?
Max, I don't feel like talking.
What's wrong?
Nathan Prescott, little rich bitch kid. He thinks he can own people like his parents own Blackwell. Like he owns the Vortex Club.
Yes, he's a nasty piece of work.
You know him.
I busted him today with a gun.
What? Seriously?
I saw him wave a gun around today and I went to the principal. We'll see what happens next.
You are my new hero. Finally, karma comes to Blackwell.
That's Luke Parker. Zach.
I'm glad you told me that, Max. Let's talk later. Cool?
Come on, Logan. Bring it, Brock. Yeah!
I need to go to my room and return Warren's flash drive. The Prescott dormitory? Good lord, Nathan's family owns my dorm? I feel like Alyssa and I should be better friends.
Oh. Hi, Max.
How are you doing?
Fantastic. I'm by myself for eating chiclet. Pretty soon I'll be bonding with Victoria at the Vortex Club.
I think you're better off reading chiclet.
Good point. Now if you'll excuse me.
I feel like Alyssa and I should be better friends. Oh. Don't take it out on the tree, loser.
Sorry. I really have to find out what happens.
Nice, bro.
This is going to be too damn cute. At least it's not a cat picture.
Awesome!
There's Kate, looking sadder than usual. Hi, Kate.
Hey, Max.
How did you like class today?
I don't remember. I guess I don't care about much of anything today.
Is there anything...
Max, I'd like to be alone, if you don't mind. I'm sorry.
Nice, bro.
Hi, Kate.
Hey, Mac.
You look down. You okay?
I'm kind of over humanity today. Sorry to be a drama queen.
Is there anything...
Mac, I'd like to be alone, if you don't mind. I'm sorry.
Glad to see our campus is eco-friendly.
Awesome!
Zachary always looks like he'd rather be throwing back a beer than a football.
Football, Max. Big football. Step away. Nice! Okay.
Hey, Logan Robertson. All-American asshole.
No, bro. You can't take a picture. You gotta wait till Friday's game.
Sorry. I really have to find out what happens.
Yeah.
Good old Samuel. Some people are creeped out by him. He's not creepy, just X-Files weird. Howdy, Samuel.
Well, hello there.
What's up with these Rachel Amber posters?
Only she would know that, right?
I guess. It just makes the campus look sad.
You can't color over that sunlight.
Awesome.
You knew Rachel?
How can you know a prism? You just stare in awe. Now I have to go paint windows.
What was she like? She must have been popular.
Even sunlight can cast shadows. Rachel did both at once, you know. She was like a battery. Positive and negative.
Nice, bro!
What do you think happened to her?
Best not to dwell on the past. Samuel looks forward. Like a clock.
See you later, Samuel.
And watch your step around here, Max. After I sweep, I paint.
Sweet!
Sorry, Max. No more talk. I have to finish this before I paint.
Oh, shit. There's Victoria and her mean girls.
Oh, look, it's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell.
What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your waif hipster bullshit.
The Daguerrean process, sir.
You could barely even say that.
I guess you got your meds filled.
No.
Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't moving. Oh, wait. Yeah. Hold that pose. So original. Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie?
Oh, yes, Victoria. I'll get your bony ass out of my way. I could crank the sprinkler up and give Victoria and her clones incentive to beat it. I don't want to mess with that ladder and hurt poor Samuel. I just want to get Victoria the hell out of the way.
There goes Samuel da Vinci to paint the window. This main sprinkler valve looks easy enough to use. Okay, let's see if this works.
Ow. Oh, dude. Awesome.
Close, but no cigar. They have to be right under the bucket.
What the hell?
I don't want to mess with that ladder and hurt poor Samuel. A paint bucket next to Victoria. I see a plan. Okay, let's see if this works. A paint bucket next to Victoria. Okay, let's see if this works.
There goes Samuel da Vinci to paint the window.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
Sweet.
Okay, let's see if this works.
Okay, Victoria?
Oh, Samuel, sorry. Wet paint is not good for hair, nope. Sorry.
Get the hell away from me, weirdo!
Hold on. We'll get some towels. We'll be right back.
So move your ass before I dry.
It worked. Don't mess with Max, bitches. Oh, man, she looks so sad and lonely sitting there alone. Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
I am sorry. That's an awesome cashmere coat.
It was.
No.
But there'll be another.
Well, you always seem to know how to pick the right outfits.
I do have some talent. Mr. Jefferson told me.
I've seen your pictures. You have a great eye. Richard Avedon-esque.
He's one of my heroes. Thanks, Max. I hope those sluts get me a towel before they hang a sign on me. You deserve a better shot. Sorry about blocking you and the go fuck your selfie.
That was mean, but pretty funny.
Just one of those days, you know?
I know exactly what you mean, Victoria. I'll see you later.
Yeah. Au revoir.
Victoria probably played me. I should have played her. Better get to my room before I find Warren.
Don't say a word, Max.
Oh, wait. Hold that pose. And no filter needed before I post this.
Oh, dude.
Now please move. I've had a messed up day and I'm going to my room.
You do that? I know where you live. So does Nathan.
Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Now I have to get to my room, then see Warren. I am. Victoria probably played me. I should have played her. Better get to my room before I find Warren. Room 217? No way in hell am I ever going in here. Room 217? No way in hell am I ever going in here. Welcome to Black Hill. Is this a Vortex Club or a Victoria Club initiation? Truly pathetic. I'd love to make a photo collage of every person who've posted these. Man, people here are merciless. Dane is still a cheerleader at heart. Juliet, extreme reporter. Looks like nobody won this TP war. There's nothing left but ghosts. At least that's an alarm from this century. We get it, she's missing. Somebody has gone crazy with these posters. They live. Okay, this is just mean and stupid. This is like the public DNA of our dorm.
Oh, Victoria, give me a fucking break.
Warren should be all over Brooke. They're perfect for each other.
How sad. I didn't write anything. I have nothing to say. Obvious, but true. Home sweet home, my favorite cocoon. I should hit the thrift store and pick up some dollar vinyl. Is that too hipster? I don't care. Music inspires me in my photography. Warren even left me a little message with his flash drive. He's such a goofball.
Don't you know that I'll be around to guide you through your weakest moments to leave them behind you? Returning nightmares, only shadows. Cast sunlight.
Hard to believe I'm 18. Do I look any older? Just more stressed. Ahoy, Captain. At least I know you've got my back. When I swallowed your eye and my parents rushed me to the ER, I knew we were bonded forever. So cheesy, but it makes me smile thinking of the day Mom and I sewed that together. The Max Caulfield Photo Memorial Wall. I love that Mom sent me a fat box of chocolate coconut bites for my birthday and slipped in a $200 gift certificate. She sure knows how to make a sad birthday happy. It's not exactly pretty and pink, but no shits are given. I like my wardrobe. Would Man Ray call them selfie portraits? It's such a pretty guitar. I need to play it more. Max and Chloe, best friends forever. Who even says that anymore? I'm going to have to call Chloe eventually and find out what she'll say. The longer I wait, the worse it'll be. Idiot. Cartier-Bresson, Doisneau, Hamilton, the greatest. I'm glad Kate let me borrow her copy of The October Country. I should have every Bradbury book for myself. I'll miss going to the games with my dad. Go Thunderbirds. If I'm not looking through a viewfinder, I'm looking through a window. Always looking. I haven't forgotten you, little Lisa. Yet. You are thirsty. I'm the worst baby mama. Drink up. One day I'll organize my film collection. One day I'll get an actual HDTV. Looks like Dana left me a little post-it note. Great. Now I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's room. Here's my go-to source for instant photo inspiration. Philip Lorca de Corsia, my man. I don't think I could take my camera to those places. Look at that shot. I love Julia Cameron's Victorian vibe. Talk about analog cameras. Ah, Dolly, what a fantastic eye. He could truly freeze time. There's my poor laptop begging me to check in. Daniel has so much talent. I hope nobody hates on it just because it's me. I am so addicted to this site. Look at these vintage beauties. Warren makes me laugh. It's nice to feel like I already made a real friend here. Warren makes me laugh. It's nice to feel like I already made a real friend here. That's the only tourist picture I let them take of me at the Space Needle. That was a good hockey game and a great fight. Man, Kristen and Fernando were so drunk hanging on the Fremont Troll.
You can't get out now, Dana. So tell me the truth or rot in there.
Welcome to the real drama queens of Blackwell. Oh, Victoria, give me a fucking break. Juliet looks like she's ready to throw down. Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
What did she do?
What didn't she do? Dana's been sexting with my boyfriend.
Ouch. How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk. Just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Juliet Watson. Duh.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do. Just because I don't talk a lot doesn't mean I don't care. So, how did you find out about them?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria? Huh.
She saw the sext, and Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything, but I bet Victoria did. I know the proof is in her room.
Speaking of selfies, let's play a little photo Tetris and leave Victoria a message. Let's move this here, and this one there. A pattern is emerging. That's mean, but she earned it. Dior, Givenchy, you could pay for my tuition with that wardrobe. Those boots are made for walking runways. That is a tasty plasma. Maybe I could sneak in and watch Final Fantasy Spirits Within. I don't care what anybody says, that's one of the best sci-fi films ever made. I bet Victoria put Juliet on her shit list after this article. Victoria hates Rachel Amber this much? How insecure. Victoria is a real Jefferson groupie. Yes, I get it. Enter the Vortex Club. No. Okay, if I did wear expensive jewelry, I would wear this for sure. No, officer, I'm not snooping. Just admiring Victoria's cutting-edge tech. She's actually got a classic medium-format camera with some awesome prime lens. I hate you, Victoria. Ouch. Well, at least she puts her photographs out there. Unlike me. Whoa, I had no idea Victoria's parents owned the Chase space. Color me impressed. They should call this series aloof. Cold and soulless. Kinda like... Is she going to get a 3D printer for her dorm room? Maybe I will join her posse. Yes, Victoria has the best Retina screen laptop. Let me just check to see if she posted my picture. I'll give Victoria props for not posting my photo. And for this nice shot. Boom! This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast. This isn't even recycled paper.
Victoria's not doing her part to save the Earth. This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent. Juliet, read this.
Of course.